What you are learning during your PhD is how to learn. So the actual topic itself is not nearly as important as the PI who will teach you and the culture in the lab and what you will learn about how to learn and how to do research.
Every laboratory is a little bit different in the way it runs, the way that the people interact, the standards and expectations. I've seen so many students make these decisions thinking about the prestige of the lab instead of really thinking about what is the environment that I need to thrive in.
Typically, in graduate school, you'll go through a number of different rotations where you get to try on different labs, and the goal is to see if it's a good fit.
Each of those experiences is going to be sort of like speed dating and trying to establish connections within that lab and spending the time to sort of suss out how well the students and the postdocs are being supported in that particular lab.
Is it that they are individually, each person's pursuing a different type of research project? Are they working together collaboratively in subgroups? Are you just working with a mentor, or are there like postdoctoral mentors and also senior graduate student mentors that kind of build into this scientific community? And what is the best fit for you? When I was rotating and having an exit interview with the different professors, I would ask them what projects that I would be pursuing during my time in graduate school. I would also ask them who would be training me. And then third, I asked if I was able to get a teaching position, would they help me and would they support me in this teaching position? And of all of the labs that I rotated in, only Don McLean said yes.
When I was doing rotations, I really paid attention to how people interacted, what type of tone was set in the lab. Did I feel welcome? Did I feel embraced? Did I feel like I was a nuisance? You know, kind of like just someone who was there in the machinery of things that were already happening? Or did I really feel like I was being supported and nurtured? And just the philosophy, the mentoring philosophy of the PI, how often did we meet? How did he or she communicate with students and postdocs or members of the lab?
Certain labs and certain professors have strong reputations for supporting students from underrepresented groups and supporting students with marginalized social identities.
If there are things that you value, like, oh, do we have group outings? Like, do we have team building activities? Do we have a lab retreat? Right? Or are we only here just seeing each other at the bench? Some people really want that. Oh, I already have a lot of friends. I just want to work.
Understanding that what you need to be successful and what someone else needs to be successful can be absolutely different.
So you may have rotated through all the labs and you're not 100% certain which lab you want to join, schedule follow-up meetings. So that happens frequently with the students that rotate in my lab. They come back and they say, well, I'm really interested in the lab. I enjoyed my rotation. I'd like to talk to you about, well, what might a thesis project look like? And maybe they might have some questions as to the type of support that they'll get in their project, and that's an opportunity for us to talk about it more explicitly.
There are certain fields where the norm is you go from undergrad to grad school directly matched with someone. So you almost have to basically sign on the dotted line with a research advisor before you even start grad school.
If you're not allowed to rotate in your program, talking to alumni of the lab is a crucial, if possible, step. If you reach out to them, they will likely talk to you. You can get a lot of information about what that experience is going to be like. And you really only have to ask one question. Would you choose that lab again? And then just say, tell me more about that, and see what they have to say.
And that is actually a great way to figure out what that lab's going to be like to join, what it's going to be like to be a grad student in the lab. The challenge is actually listening. So sometimes you hear about less than ideal experiences and you think it's going to be different for you. Don't do that. Actually listen to folks.
I sent a friend on this journey as she was choosing a postdoc lab to interview alumni of the lab. And she came back to me and she said, well, two of the people in the lab told me that when it came to authorship on papers, the PI had some real issues. And in one case, someone told me that she was supposed to be first author on a paper. And when it came time to submit, the PI said that this man in the lab needed it more. So she was going to be second author and she would have her shot at a first author paper later. There are so many problems with this story that I cannot even begin to tell you. The person said to me, but this wouldn't happen to me. I know how to speak up for myself. And she joined that lab. If someone gives you a red flag, pick a different lab.
You have to try different things on. You'll know when it works and not.
You really have to decide, is that the kind of experience that I want to have? And there's no single one right answer.